Hey guys, it's Nerd E here, and today I'm going to be doing a run of the Arkham Horror campaign, Night of the Zealots, Part 2. I've done Part 1. I have done Curse of the Rougarou in between, and now I'm going to be doing the Midnight Masks. So let's just go ahead and start reading the intro for this. In the wake of the disaster at your home, Lita Chandler, the red-haired woman from your parlor, lays out a tale that, even in light of what you have just witnessed, strains the limits of your belief. The creatures in your home, she claims, are called ghouls, cruel beings who plague the crypts, caverns, and tunnels beneath the city of Arkham. These creatures feed on the corpses of humans, and they are served by a dark cult within Arkham whose members have inexplicably come to worship the ancient master of the ghouls. This cult has been killing innocent people and feeding them to the ghouls, satiating a monstrous hunger. A dark balance was maintained until now. Recently, Lita continues, one of their lairs, where the corpses were stored, was destroyed. Since then, the ghouls have been more active than usual. I have tracked their movements and tried my best to stop them from running amok throughout the city. But I think there is something worse going on. The cult has been planning something darker and more ominous than anything I have yet observed. Indications are that this plan shall come to fruition tonight, shortly after midnight. Beyond that, I can't fathom what to expect. Many of the cultists, Lita continues, will seem like everyday people, despite their foul intentions. Whenever the cult meets, its members don masks shaped like the skulls of various animals to protect their identities from one another. These masks are our mark, symbols of death and decay. We must unmask the cultists to expose and derail their plans. We have but a few hours. The more cultists we find before midnight, the better. So we've got the setup here. We've set aside our cultist deck, which is going to be up here. You can't really see it, but that's where it's at. Trust me. We have the same setup as before. We're playing it on easy. We start in Rivertown because our house, we destroyed it in the first part, which was a good thing, I think. I'm hoping it was anyway. So let's start by reading Predator of Prey. The agenda. Lita seems convinced of a conspiracy within the city of Arkham. She believes that a secret cult serves the ghouls that live in the crypts beneath the city, and that several of the cult's prominent members are scattered throughout Arkham. As you begin searching for them, you can't shake the feeling that you too are being hunted. I can resign at any point and say I'm out. The act says, uncovering the conspiracy, you have one night to find the members of the cult and unveil their plan. The more members of the cult you can find and interrogate before midnight, the better. I can do an action. I can spend two clues per investigator to draw the top card of the cultist deck. My objective is to find as many as I can, but if I find six, then I can basically flip that over and be done with the scenario. I am going to draw my hand. See what I've got. We've got a very good hand, so I'm going to keep all of those cards. Got Lita, my special gun, manual dexterity, elder sign amulet, and emergency cash. All of those will work nicely. Starting out in Rivertown, the banks of the Miskatonic River are lined with docks, warehouses, and small shops in a district aptly named Rivertown. It's going to have one clue on it. There's something unsettling about the water of the Miskatonic River tonight. It ripples and bubbles as though something is moving beneath the surface. So that's interesting, to say the least. I think I'm going to try to figure out what's the best course of action for me. I think I will play Lita Chandler down for, that's one action. Play my asset emergency cash to get three resources, and then spend three resources to put my Roland special 38 special down. I think that seems like a good course of action. That'll be my three actions for this round. There's no enemies, so I'm gonna go ahead and go to getting a resource and drawing a card. It's guts, which is not bad, and then we will place a token here and draw a card here. Hunting Shadow, Revelation. You must either choose one, spend a clue, or take two damage. Well, I don't have any clues, but I'll give the two damage to Lita. All right, now it's my turn. I'm going to spend two resources to play the Elder Sign Amulet. And then I'm going to try to get this clue from here, which is in the second action. I have a 3, it's a 1, I'm just going to keep it vanilla. And I got 0, so that worked, got the clue. And I'm going to move to the south side for my final action. middle-class houses with gambrel roofs crowd together between the streets of Southside. The neighborhood is known for its cultural and social landmarks such as South Church, Miles Boarding House, and the Historical Society. And we got the Historical Society. You randomly pick one of two of those cards, and I got the Historical Society. An action I can do there is draw three cards. I can do it once per game. The Georgian Manor housing the Historical Society is well known for its private library, where local records, maps, and artifacts from Markham's past hint at secrets better left alone. So that's kind of creepy, but that's okay. I am done, because that's the three actions. I will get a resource, draw a card. It's magnifying glass, and then place token, draw top card. Wizard of Order, spawn any empty location, and it can retaliate. At the end of the Mythos phase, place one doom on the Wizard Order. I will put this guy St. Mary's, because I'm going to go there next, hopefully. And now he's got that on there. So, first thing I can do... is... I will... I think I'm going to... If I attempt to check, and attempt to check once, if I fail, then I'll just move. So I'm going to take the check. I'm not going to use any cards for the attempt. So it's a 3 to a 3. Minus 2, so I failed. Now I'm going to move my second action and my third action. I'm going to attack the Wizard of the Order. I have... Oh, I didn't put my ammo on my gun. I'm going to use the gun, which is going to give... Or first, I'm going to see what the St. Mary's Hospital has to say. Arkham's only hospital, St. Mary's, has a 24-hour receiving room and is busy at all hours of the night. Dr. Mortimer and Nurse Sharon have been particularly stressed lately, thanks in part to recent events. I can heal 3 damage, and it has a clue on it. An extended stay at St. Mary's can do wonders for your body, but its effects on one's psyche is unclear. So I'm going to spend Roland's special. I'm going to do an ammo. I get plus 3 to my fight. So now I have a 7. I have an 8 because of Lita. I'm going to do 1 damage and then 1 damage because of Lita. So I'm going to do 3 damage. So I have an 8 fight to its 4. And I kill it. So that goes away. I've defeated that guy. And when I defeat a villain or enemy, I get a token. So that's the end of my turn. I will get a resource, draw a card. Got a 45 automatic. All right. Put a token here. Draw a card. It's an acolyte. After acolyte enters play, place one doom on it, any empty location. So we're going to place that at Miskatonic University. So we're at 4 doom markers now. Start of my turn. I am going to... Spend my 2 clues to get the top card from this deck. Wolfman, the cannibal. Downtown is where I put him, and he's a pretty evil-looking guy. So let's go for my second action to Miskatonic University. Miskatonic University is one of the most prestigious colleges in the Northeast. The university library is famous for its collection of occult books maintained by the esteemed Dr. Henry Armitage. I'm just going to get 2 clues on it. Search the top 6 cards of your deck for a tome or spell. Ooh, that's nice. So, my final action for the round, I'm going to spend my ammo to get a fight on this acolyte. I'm going to have... I'm not going to use the ammo. I don't need to. I'll have a 1 plus 2 is a 5 against his 3 normally, and I'll do multiple damage on him anyway. So I just need better than nothing worse than minus 2. Okay, that is minus 3. If you fail, place your clues on the location. So I don't have any clues, but I did fail. And that's unfortunate. So now it's going to be the enemy's phase. It's going to hit me for 1 damage, but I'll take that. I'm not going to give that to Lita. I don't want her to die. Then I am going to get card, resource, working on a hunch. And then we were going to place token there. If there's 5 out right now. Haunting Shadow Revelation, you must either spend 1 clue or take 2 damage. I have no clues, so I'll take 2 damage. I'll just replace that one with a 3. And I'm going to start this round off by trying to defeat the acolyte again. Again, I'm not going to use any of my resources. I'm hoping that I don't draw badly. I drew this. Minus is the highest number of doom on a cultist enemy in play. He has one, so it's a 4 to my 5, so I do defeat him. And when I defeat an enemy, I get the clue. It's one action. I'll spend 2 resources to work on a hunch, which allows me to discover 1 clue at your location. 2, and then for 3, I will spend the 2 to draw the top card here. Spawn her at the north side. I can spend 5 resources to get her in the victory display. Alright, draw a resource, draw a card. Encyclopedia, that's not bad. And put a Doom Tracker marker and draw a card. Crypt Chill, Revelation. It's a head test 4. If you fail, choose and discard 1 asset you control. If you cannot, take 2 damage. I'm going to use my guts with that, so I have a 5 to its 4. And I passed, so if successful, draw a card. Got first aid. Alright, my turn. I have 6 resources. I can get her. Okay, I'm going to move to the north side. North side is a commercial district that contains many offices and factories as well as the train station. Flip it over, and now I can spend 5 resources to gain 2 clues from the token pool, or I can spend. So my first action will be spending 3, 4, 5 resources to get her into the victory pile. Then it's 2 actions so far. Oh, I need to put 2 clue tokens on there. That's what I was looking for. And third action, I'm going to spend my resource to play the magnifying glass down. So that's going to help me with my lore checks. End of the round, he doesn't move anywhere. Everything's going to get fixed. I'm going to get a resource and draw a card. Cover up. Oof, that's bad news for this game. Anytime I would get a clue, I discard one of those clues and cover up instead. That's going to delay my game significantly. Put one there. So as soon as that happens, these come off. Well, not as soon as it happens. So first I'm going to draw another. Place 2 doom on the nearest cultist enemy. If there are no cultist enemies, then search the encounter deck. So I would put 2 of these here. And when I failed this, basically this guy is going to be spawned, the masked hunter. He goes attached to me, and he's going to have 6 health. So it's my turn. I'm going to basically try and defeat this guy. So I'm going to spend this. I'm going to have 3, 4, plus I have an 8 attack to his 4, and I'll be doing 3 damage. Did hit him for 3. I'm going to try and hit him again. Still using the gun, so 8 attack to his 4. And did it again, so he is defeated. And I get one of those clues, but it's actually going to be taking away the clue from here, so it stays on there actually, but I take it away from my cover-up. My third action, I'm going to attempt that location, so I can basically get this one off there. I'll have a 4 to its 3. I'll discard and see what PD to make it 5 to its 3. And I didn't need it, but that's okay. Remove that, turns over, he doesn't move. Get a resource and a card. Emergency cash. Alright, that's not bad. And put a token here, there's now 3 tokens. Empty location, acolyte. I'll place him at East Town, and he's going to get a doom token. So there's now 1, 2, 3, 4 doom tokens out of 8. That's bad. But now it's my turn. I need to kill this wolf man. So let's just move over here for 1 action. The downtown area of Arkham is filled with government buildings, including City Hall, the First Bank of Arkham, Independence Square, and Arkham Asylum. Can also be found in this area. It's the busiest district in the area, so that's going to go there. And my second action, I'm going to attack him with my gun, trying to do 3 damage to him. I have 8 to his 4. I still hit him, so that does 3 damage to him. I lose my gun, but I'm going to do 1 more attack. I have a 1, 2, 6 to his 4, and I'll do 2 damage to him. And I hit him, and that kills him. These go away. He goes up here, and I get that, but that means I get it off the cover-up, so that's done there. My turn's over. Get a resource and a card. Vicious Blow. I'm going to add a token here. Draw a card. On the Wings of Darkness, Revelation, test agility. If you fail, take 1 damage and 1 horror. Then disengage and go to a central location. So I'm going to have... I'm going to use manual dexterity. It's going to make me have 4. And let's just see. Hopefully I can pass. 4 to 4. Check. And it's a -3. So that was even worse. So I failed. I take a damage and a horror. So I'm going to take the damage... I'm going to give the horror to Lita. And I have to move to the central location. All right. Okay, first things I want to do is... I'm going to move to East Town. East Town's neighborhood, situated on the northern banks of the Miskatonic River, contains lower-class housing, the Arkham Police Station, and the popular eateries like Velma's Diner. And while you're in East Town, reduce the cost of each ally asset you play by 2. The second thing I want to do is I'm going to attack him. I've got a 5 attack, and so I've got a 5 attack to his 3. And I fail. I also need to put a clue there. I'm going to try again. 5 to his 3. And I pass. I defeat him. I get the clue when I defeat him. That's the end of the turn. I get a resource and a card. Unexpected courage. Okay, so now... Put a token, that's 3 on there. Acolyte, spawn in any empty location. After Acolyte enters play, place 1 Doom on him. So let's put him in downtown, since I'm going to try and go back that way. There's 4 Doom tokens out. So I'm going to leave East Town to go after him. I'm going to try fighting him. And I beat him, did the damage to him, get the clue. And I have 1 more action. I'm going to use the clues to spawn a cultist, I guess. Herman Collins. He spawns in the graveyard. I can choose and discard 4 cards from my hand to get him in my victory pile. Okay, that's cool. That was my last action. I will draw a card. Lady Esprit. Get a resource. And I will... be putting a token. That's 4. Draw a card. Locked door. Attach the locked door to the most clues on a location. While it's locked, you can't investigate there. So I'll place it there. That's bad because I have to go there to get those clues. Instead, I can actually go down and get Herman. Let's move. So I have to go there, there. And I can't get to the graveyard unless I go to Rivertown. And I can't get to Rivertown from downtown. Guess we'll go the north side. One. We're going to try to fight the door. Yeah, I think we're going to try and fight the door, which is going to be a 4 check, and I have 5. Got it. That's 2, and then the third thing I'm going to do is try and get a clue from that, which is going to be, I'm using my unexpected courage, so I'll have 6 to its 3. And I passed. So I got one of those clues. And that's the end of the turn. We're going to take a resource, draw a card. Flashlight, 2, 4, 6 cards. Put a token, draw a card. False lead, revelation. If you have no clues, false lead, gain search. If you have one more clues, test your book. 4. For each point you fail by, place one of your clues on the location. So I have clues. It's a book check. I've got 1. Let's use the flashlight for 2. We're going to have 6 total. We don't need to use the flashlight then. So we'll have 5 total. 2, it's... what was the check? It's a 4. Okay, yeah, let's use the flashlight. So it's 6, so it's 4. And we failed. And a little clue there. That's bad. We... We can't win. I don't think we're having a lot of hard time trying to get this movement around and not enough time left in the game. Try to do the check twice, which I'm a 5, I'm 4 to its 3 right now. So let's do the check once, 4 to 3. Passed. It's 1 token. 4 to 3. Passed. And I'll spin the clues to get the next to last guy out. She goes to St. Mary's Hospital. It's the end of the turn. I'm going to put one of those there. It's 6 of 8, which is really bad. And draw a card here. Hunter, while attempting to evade hunting, Night Gaunt, double the negative modifier of each revealed chaos token. Awesome. So we basically have 2 more rounds. We need to get both of these guys and that one to get all 6, and I don't think we're going to be able to do that. But we can get close, maybe. We can get a couple more. So let's see what we can figure out. We definitely need to evade the hunting Night Gaunt. So to do so, we have 2 to its 1, but it doubles whatever I draw. Do I just risk it and hope that I get a good draw? I think I'm going to. So it became, it beat me by that. I'm going to try it again. Beat me again in the third action. I'm going to try it again. And it beat me again. So that was unfortunate. Now it's going to attack me. It's going to do a head and a brain and a damage to me. Then we're going to put token on here, draw a card. Falsely revelation, if you have no clues, it gains surge. So it's not really going to matter because it's going to be over before we can finish, but I'm going to look up what surge is because I don't remember what that word means. Oh, you just draw another card. Okay, so let's draw this. You must either choose spend a clue or take 2 damage. Well, I don't have any clues, so I'll take 2 damage. My turn. I can't even get to anywhere that has a cultist. So, I feel like I should resign. I'm going to resign because I can't finish, so I'm resigning. Resigning, is that going to be different, is the question, from losing. So let's look it up. If your resolution was not reached, you should basically get a resign or is defeated. Read resolution 1. So that's what we're going to read. You've managed to obtain some useful information about the cult and its plans. You can only hope it's enough. In your campaign log, under cultists, we interrogated, record the names of each unique cultist enemy in the victory display. So we've got Wolfman Drew, Victoria Devereux, the Masked Hunter. So we've got three of them. And then we record the ones that got away, which would be three more, I'm assuming. If the Gold Priest is in the victory display, cross it, well, we've already killed him. Each investigator earns experience equal to the victory value of each card in the victory display. So we'd be getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to our one that we already had. So that's 7 victory points. So that's pretty good. So we got 7 victory points. 7 victory points, but there's three names that we didn't get. So that's where we're going to end it. I'm going to do another video of picking my cards off using my 7 victory points, but I'm also going to do another video, which will be me doing the Carnival of Horrors. So I'll need to save 2 of those victory points to be able to do that. So thanks for watching. I was moderately successful, and I hope that you enjoyed watching me play the second mission on Night of Zealots, the Midnight Masks. Thanks, guys.